Our topic of today is performing arts. Performing arts has more influence than the other arts because usually it has characteristic as a type of democratic art. Moreover, in a large part of Southeast Asian arts found outside of the museum, it has a special power for common people. Our topic will begin with potehi, a type of Taiwanese globe puppet, and later changed to the puppet theater in Vietnam and Myanmar. In the last chapter, we will see shadow plays in Indonesia and Cambodia. Today, we will see two places in Taiwan, which are Taipei and Xiluo in Yunlin. Taiwan has a famous puppet theater, which is named Potehi in Taiwanese or Butaiji in Mandarin. In this time, I will use time of Taiwanese because this performing art originated in Zhuangzhou, southern Fujian, and it well known as Potehi elsewhere in the world. In the present time, we can still easily see the playing of Potehi in Taiwan, especially at traditional shrine areas such as shown in the left picture. Ordinarily, it was performed in small theaters such as in the right picture. This Taipei Puppet Theater Museum is an old theater in Taipei, and it is one of Taiwan's very unique small museums. In the present time, the performance of Potehi are more frequently shown on TV, and several new characters are very popular among Taiwanese, especially with the young generation as seen in these pictures. It is believed that Potehi was first born in Zhuangzhou from at least before the 17th century. These are some of the old style Potehi puppet exhibited in the Taipei Puppet Theater Museum. Potehi puppets are played by the single hand of actors, and therefore this performing art is categorized as a globe puppet performance, as seen in these pictures. The performing method of Potehi are totally different from other kinds of puppet theater performances, such as with marionettes, although both are puppet theater performances. The traditional style of Potehi is played on a relatively small stage. The present type of stage is usually decorated with vivid coloring and electric lighting for performances at night, as seen in the left pictures. However, the old style stage was simply made of manufactured wood and had a musician's space at each side, as seen in the right picture. It is very interesting that the Potehi is also very much loved by Indonesian Chinese because a large part of their ancestors originated from southern Fujian. Even now, there are traditional stories performed at several large cities in Java Island, such as seen in these pictures. In the present time, Potehi is sometimes performed in the common space as seen in the left picture. And the players are not only Indonesian Chinese descendants, but also aboriginal people, especially Javanese, such as in the right pictures. Because Javanese have their own traditional puppet theater called wayang, as will be explained in later, they probably find it quite easy to enjoy Potehi as well. In this case, Potehi has acted as a common cultural element for both Taiwanese with Indonesian Chinese as well as Japanese. Now we will change to the puppet theater in Vietnam and Myanmar. we will see the condition in Hanoi, Vietnam, and Yangon in Myanmar. Among the puppet theaters in Southeast Asia or elsewhere in the world, I believe that Vietnamese water puppet play or Muaroi Nuoc is the most exciting performing act. Performed on the water or on the commonly formed small pools in the present time. These plays have many kinds of wooden puppets, which moved quickly or sometimes dance as can be seen in this picture. The practice of this performance around the Red River area close to Hanoi has been recorded since the 11th century. In the present time, this performance is played in the pool, which is set up inside of a large theater such as in the left picture. Due to its uniqueness, this is also performed in the downtown of Hanoi and is always crowded with foreign visitors, as seen in the right picture. In the modern theater, besides the pool is located the place of musicians, such as seen in the left picture. However, ordinarily this performance was practiced on a natural lake, and the players of puppet handled in the water. Therefore, this performing act has close relation with the freshwater culture of ancient Vietnamese. Many of the puppets are manufactured with a comical expression, such as in the right picture. And of course, some of them have an image related to freshwater life. For example, a boy riding on the water buffalo, such as in the left picture. Also, a narrow boat, similar to the dragon boat, is frequently presented in several scenes. A huge white boat puppet are possible to be seen in the Taipei Puppet Theater Museum, shown in the left picture. The old man without clothes on the puppet body sort of a symbolic image of the freshwater culture. On the roof of this museum, there is a small pool for the training of puppet acting, such as in the light pictures. This is a scene of my acting. In Southeast Asia, there is the most famous marionette play in Myanmar, the so-called Hutwe O. Myanmar is a multi-ethnic nation, but this marionette is a traditional performance of Burmese, the majority ethnicity in this country. This play is usually combined with a live human dance, which copies the movement of the marionette. Sometimes we cannot understand the performance of the marionette or human dancers. These two pictures are typical Myanmar marionettes collected in the Taipei Puppet Theater Museum. It is very clear that these marionettes are controlled by many strings, as like a common marionette. By this condition, the moving of these marionettes can be done smoothly. In Southeast Asia, there are many kinds of traditional performing arts, including the puppet theater. However, the marionette play is not commonly used by many ethnicities in this area. In such a condition, the traditional tradition of this old Burmese performing act is succeeded by the young generation, as seen in these pictures. Now, we will change to the shadow plays in Southeast Asia. Typically, there are very famous performers in the ancient capital of Yogyakarta in Indonesia and Siem Reap in Cambodia. as one of the famous shadow players in the world, the Indonesian wayang kulit is very well known. This performing act is played in Java and Bali Island, Indonesia, and also can be seen in Kelantan in Malaysia. This picture shows the condition of playing Java in 1890. Wayang kulit means leather performance in Japanese. The puppet was manufactured from the leather of a water buffalo, such as seen in the light picture, and the puppet was used for shadow playing. Therefore, the shadow was the puppet. Seen in the left picture is of the puppet in the performance image seen on the light picture. Most performances are based on a small part of the two ancient Indian epics, Mahabharata or Ramayana. However, the actual story is told by the player in an ad-lib style. Many of the Mahabharata are formed by a unique Java style, and each character is well known by most people in Java. The player of puppet in the only one who is called Dara is in Japanese. His role is not limited to the playing of the puppets, but also he or she acts as a storyteller and a conductor of musicians. And at each beginning and ending, a special puppet is set in the center of the screen. That is a gunungan, the symbol of the holy mountain, such as seen in the light picture. Each time, the Dalang player handles about 100 kinds of puppets with the conducting of musicians, and the program continued all night from evening until the next morning. During this long time, the Dalang is playing without rest. Therefore, this performance is not a modern style show, but one of an important element in the traditional ceremonies. At the first step of its manufacturing, each puppet is carved on the leather, such as seen in the left picture. And in the next step, the carved one is painted, which is seen in the right picture. As a result, the final image of each puppet is totally different with the Indian epic heroes of the same name. Besides the leather made puppet for shadow play in Eastern Java, there is also a wooden puppet such as seen in the left picture. And in Bali, Bali Island, located very close to the east end of Java, the leather puppet has evolved in its stories and characters. But just as with other Japanese cultures in Bali, the appearance has changed a little, as can be seen in the light pictures. Another important shadow play in Southeast Asia is found in Cambodia. In this ancient Khmer culture, there are two kinds of shadow play performances, a large type and a small type. The small type is almost the same as the wayang kulit in Java, but the large type, spektrum, is quite different. One playing handled only one shadow puppet. Therefore, many players are needed for the playing of a performance. The basic raw material of spektrum are almost the same as with the wayang kulit, that is, the leather of the water buffalo. And after finished carving two long Latin sticks, a handle is set. This large puppet does not have any movable parts. And therefore, a vivid action of the players is needed, as like as the dancing style seen in the light picture. The basic story of the Svek tomb is based on an Indian epic Ramayana, which is called Ramkel in Khmer. A similar sized shadow play with the same story is also found in Thailand, such as shown in the light pictures. Much of Thai culture originated from Khmer culture, and therefore in this large sized shadow play was introduced from the Khmer to the Thai. Performing arts in Southeast Asia have several similarities among different countries, which also relate to the cultural history of Taiwan. A good way to understand this condition is to visit the Taipei Puppet Theater Museum. This private museum, located in Xinyin Northern Road, is relatively small scale. However, its basic concept stands on very wide perspectives. I think this museum is a proud symbol of Taiwan society and its relationship with Asia.